Hello and welcome to episode 6 of Flags and Foods. I am Mr. Flag and I'm excited to take you through a journey of flags and food. Let's say hello to the other half of the Flags and Foods team, Mr. and Mrs. Food.
Kia ora.
Kia ora.
Kia ora. I don't have anyone to rub the nose with. Let's see where the greeting is from. These are the three clues. Clue number one. It is the first country in the world to give voting right to women as far back as 1893. Clue number two. This country has the highest sheep to human ratio at 6:1. Clue number three. The entire Lord of the Rings movie series was shot in this country. To facilitate the shooting, the country even appointed a Lord of the Rings minister, and they even at times broadcast news in the Elvish language. This one should be an easy guess. If you haven't, it is New Zealand. I visited New Zealand in 2010. New Zealand is part of Oceania and is located in the Southwest Pacific Ocean. It is a country of stunning and diverse natural beauty, rolling pastelands, dazzling fjords, pristine lakes, raging rivers, scenic beaches, active volcanic zones, and snow-capped mountains of the Southern Alps are some of the scenic highlights of New Zealand. The Maori culture and tradition lend a distinct level of diversity to New Zealand. New Zealand top 5 attractions. 1. Milford Sound. Milford Sound is a stunning natural fjord located on New Zealand's South Island. On a cruise through Milford Sound, one can experience vast remote wilderness of white snow-capped mountains, glacial lakes and valleys, waterfalls, and dense rainforests. 2. Queenstown. It is a dream destination for those in search of adrenaline and adventure. Surrounded by the towering peaks of the Southern Alps and right on the banks of deep blue Lake Wakatipu, Queenstown is also an incredibly beautiful spot. Do check more about Queenstown in the story section. 3. Rotorua. The Maori heartland of New Zealand, Rotorua is best known for its geothermal activity. There are numerous geysers and hot springs in and around the city, with the most famous one being Wai Otapu with its colorful springs and spouting geysers. Also, don't miss to try a hangi feast, which is a traditional meal cooked over the region's hot rocks at the Whakariwariwa Geothermal Park. 4. Auckland. Known as a city of sails, Auckland is the largest and most populous city in New Zealand. It is known for its vibrant culture and foodie landscape. The scenic and picturesque Bay of Islands, made up of 144 islands, is a 3-hour drive from Auckland. 5. Marlborough. The Marlborough wine region is a world renowned for its award-winning Sauvignon Blancs. This beautiful stretch of the South Island has put New Zealand's viticulture on the world map, as also offers some spectacular scenery as well.
Shorty, what are you doing?
Oh, sorry.
What's with all the singing?
You know, it's a Maori custom to sing to show gratitude after a meal.
We haven't had dessert yet.
Yeah, that's what you're making today, right?
Yes, indeed. It is a dessert called Pavlova. Pavlova originated in a Wellington hotel to honor the world famous ballerina Anna Pavlova when she visited Australia and New Zealand in the 1920s as part of her ballet tour. The dessert is often referred to as light as Pavlova.
To make the pavlova, we need 4 egg whites, a pinch of salt, 1 teaspoon vanilla extract, 1.5 teaspoon vinegar, 1.5 cup caster sugar, 300 ml whipped cream. Here I'm using a packet mix to make the whipped cream, and 1 cup of berries. Preheat the oven to 200. Trace a circle on a piece of baking paper on a baking sheet and invert the sheet. Beat egg whites and salt with an electric mixer. Until stiff peaks are formed. Sift the sugar and sprinkle in 1 tablespoon at a time while beating at full speed and slowly adding in all the sugar. This should take about 5 minutes. Gently fold in the vinegar and vanilla. Place a few drops of the meringue on the corners to hold the sheet in place. Scoop large spoons of this mix inside the circle on the baking sheet and smooth over the top and sides with a spatula while creating a small dip in the center. Reduce the oven temperature to 150 and bake for 1 hour. Whip the cream until stiff. After the pavlova is cooled, place it gently on the serving plate. The pavlova may crack a bit, but this is totally fine. Spoon the whipped cream on top of the pavlova. Top with berries to serve.
Hello, Junior Food.
Hello, Mr. Flag.
Welcome back.
Thank you.
Do you know which is the country for today?
It's New Zealand.
Ready for the 2 questions?
I'm up for it.
Okay. Question number 1. The New Zealanders are known by the name of a bird. Do you know what the name of that bird is? I'll give you 1 clue. There is a fruit also by the same name.
It's the kiwi.
That's right. Question number 2. Do you know what is the most popular sport in New Zealand?
It's rugby. I love the All Blacks.
Uh-huh.
Because you know why? I'm wearing black today.
You know, before each of their games, the All Black performs something. Do you know what it is called?
It's a kind of dance, but I don't remember the name.
It's not a dance. It's called a haka. Do you want to try the haka?
Okay, let's see.
Okay, cool. Ready to taste the pavlova?
As always.
So now for the verdict. The 3 hand gestures.
Okay.
Yes!
Junior Food, verdict. Wow, excellent decision. I'm going to have a surprise for you this time. There's 2 guests who are going to join us right now.
Who are they?
You'll see in a minute.
Hey!
Hey, Junior Food!
Hello, Mrs. Food! Hey, Mr. Food!
Junior Food, we wanted to thank you for giving us amazing reviews for all our dishes.
It's my pleasure.
I hope we get more double thumbs up along the way.
Of course, Mr. Food!
The pavlova actually has a meringue base. And the whipped cream and the meringue base together makes the dessert very sweet. The berries actually tone down the sweetness so that there is a right balance for the dessert. Whenever you travel to the region, there's always a very friendly banter, very good humored one between the Aussies and Kiwis as to which country the pavlova originated. But it doesn't actually matter. As long as the pavlova is as tasty as this one, it's all fine.
If you love adventure and extreme sports,
look no further than New Zealand. It is a dream haven for adrenaline junkies. You name the activity and it is there. From skydiving, to whitewater rafting, from luging to quad biking in the mountains, from glacier walks to canyon swing. There are four activities which has its origin in New Zealand. They are zorbing, blackwater rafting, jet streaming, and the most iconic of them all, bungee jumping.
Here we go, Superman. 3, 2, 1. No!
Most of these iconic adventure sports was founded by AJ Hackett, which is a name which is synonymous to adrenaline sports anywhere in the world. There is a story of how bungee jumping originated. It was known as land diving and it was inspired by locals using vine to jump from trees in the small South Pacific island of Vanuatu. And AJ Hackett commercialized the sport in 1988 by launching the first bungee jump from the Kawarau Bridge in Queenstown. Queenstown is the epicenter of adventure sports in New Zealand. And one of the best ways to finish your day after doing one of these activities is to go down to Ferg Burger, which has the most amazing burgers in the world. And it is only there in Queenstown. Wakavithai viewers, for tuning into this episode of Flags and Foods. If you liked our show, please subscribe to our channel.
Don't forget to press the bell icon.
We'll be back next week with another signature dish from another stunning country. Till then, happy cooking and keep your travel dreams alive.